Good morning. Let us discuss what is a solution, what are the types, and what are the chemical properties of a solution. Solutions are homogeneous mixtures of two or more substances. Homogeneous means particles are not identified. No boundary or separation between the particles. Example, salt water, soft drinks, etc. And solutions are made of two components. The substance we use to dissolve is called solute. The medium we use is the solvent. So, solution is a homogeneous mixture of a solute in a solvent. Example, salt water, salt is the solute and water is the solvent. See the example. Okay. Now, what are the different types of solutions based on the selection of solute and solvent? If we use solute as well as solvent to solids, that is the first type, solid, solid, solution. Both are in the solid state. Example, mixtures of metals, bronze, brass, etc. Second type, solid, liquid solution. That is, solute is a solid and solvent is in the liquid medium. Example, salt water. Third type, liquid-liquid solution, means both are in the liquid state. Example, alcohol and water. The next type, gas-liquid solution. Solute is in the gaseous state and solvent is in the liquid state. Example, soft drinks, means carbon dioxide, the gas when dissolves in water, we'll get soft drinks or soda water. And the last type, gas-gas solution. Both are in the gaseous state, means air. A perfect example of a solution in which solute as well as solvent are gases. So this is the classification of solution based on the selection of solute and solvent. See the examples also. Many examples are given in the box. Have a clean observation of all those examples. Now, moving to the next topic, that is general characteristics of solution. Solutions are homogeneous. Constant particles are mixed uniformly. There is only one phase, P-H-A-S-E phase. One phase means no separation. And boundaries of constant particles cannot be identified or distinguished. The size of particles of solution is smaller than 1 nanometer. 1 nanometer means 10 raised to minus 7 meter. Solutions do not show Tyndall effect. Tyndall effect means take a solution in a container and light a torch towards the solution. You could not see the path of light. If the path of light is visible, the appearance is called Tyndall effect. We'll have a detailed explanation. Solute cannot be separated using common methods like filtration. And solutions are stable. When we're left undisturbed, particles will not settle at the bottom. Now, based on the solubility of solute, solution is again classified into two. One simple example, have a cup of water and add 1 teaspoon of salt. Continue the addition. 10 teaspoons of salt I added. Continue, 15 reached. Can I add 15 spoons of salt in a cup of water? Sorry, no. Salt particles left behind in the solution. What is the reason? See, we studied there are spaces between particles. And in these empty spaces, foreign particles are getting seated. Once the seating capacity completed, no dissolution possible. That is why salt particles left behind in the solution. Now we call this solution as a saturated solution. A solution is said to be saturated when further dissolution of the solute particles feel difficult or impossible. Have the saturated solution on your stove. Keep this saturated solution on your stove. Start heating. What happens? Some of the particles get evaporated. And after the evaporation, spaces may be arranged. Now you can add 1 or 2 teaspoons of salt into the solution. That is, saturation will be possible. That means a saturated solution becomes unsaturated by boiling. What is the reason? Already discussed. Through boiling, empty spaces created by the evaporation of particles. So foreign particles can be added more. So if you can add solute particles into the solution, we'll call the solution as unsaturated. Saturated and unsaturated solution. Saturated solution becomes unsaturated by heating. Remember these terms: saturation, dissolution impossible. Unsaturated, we can add some more solute. That is, salt particles totally dissolved. Solubility is okay. So what is solubility? The ability of the solute particles to get into the solution. That is solubility. And based on the amount of solute particles in the solvent, we can assign the concentration or the strength of a solution. Concentration or strength means how much solute particles added. A simple example. In the morning, I prepared a cup of tea. I used a cup of water, half glass of milk, 2 teaspoons of sugar and 2 teaspoons of tea powder. I have the concentrated tea. Instead of a cup of water, if you select a bucket of water, what is it? The tea has a taste that we won't prefer. A diluted tea only. So concentration means the maximum amount of solute dissolving in the solvent. And concentration or strength is expressed in terms of mass percentage or volume percentage. Clear enough? Concentration means the amount of solute present in the solvent medium. And it is expressed in terms of mass percentage or volume percentage. The details will be continued in our next session. So that's all today. Thank you.